On the last Jordan vlog, we visited Petra for the first time, where we actually got lost twice in the same day. That was certainly a day to remember. Now, at the end of the vlog, I left you guys with a question. Do you think you would be able to wake up at 6 a.m. to visit the monastery without the crowds? And the obvious answer is no. After tidying up all of this, we finally got ready to start another day.
I have absolutely no voice today. We're sleeping in a hostel. You basically have to go all the way up the stairs. I have a restroom as well. The location is amazing. 8 minutes walk. Today we are going to follow the main path from the visitor center all the way up to the monastery for the treasury. Wherever we go, we always like to make friends with animals and with locals.
Hello. Hi, what's your name? here is black and here is green. Yeah.
Trail, which we didn't, we would end up here. Yesterday we saw no restaurants or bars or anything, but on the main trail there's loads of them. This is an area where you've got two restaurants at least. Both of them look really, really fancy. Let the steps begin.
To get to the monastery, you will have to go up about 850 steps. After finding this cute puppy, we found on the left a way towards the lion triclinium, which is quite hidden, so you won't see many people in there.
Dessert tasting part 2. This is a very popular one.
Yeah.
They sell it a lot in shops. I have no idea what it has. Sesame seeds, it looks like coconut. Pistachio, almond and honey, probably.
And also peanuts, maybe. Yeah. This part seems like peanuts.
It tastes like yogurt. It's actually really good. Not very sweet. And you can toast, you cannot taste the coconut a lot. I don't like coconut. Finally, after so many steps, it's really, 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 really big. Because of the hike we did yesterday, this hike seems so, so, so easy. Because when we did it yesterday, was super, super tiring, and it looked really, really long. So yes, Lodge is going to take some shots that we probably have lunch before we go down again and take some pictures at the treasury with less people, hopefully.
Behind the scenes.
After laying on the floor for some nice pictures, I had to prove that I could get into a bridge from a back bend, which I haven't done in about 6 years.
Okay, she's preparing herself. We're going to break your back, and then what? Done.
Not only you can take a picture at the bottom, then you can take a picture over that rock like they are doing, or from where that girl is coming, or then you can hike all the way up to the view. I think most people do that, where you can see the monastery from up top. We are short on time, so probably we're just going to do two of these, or maybe one.
After taking the pictures, we started going down until someone stopped us for a silly joke.
Excuse me. Do you have a driving license?
Car in here.
Yes.
You're driving me crazy.
So we ended up going to only one viewpoint, which was over that big stone, big rock. And we didn't go to any of the other viewpoints, simply because we took a lot of pictures from the monastery. And we wanted to spend more time in the treasury, which we didn't yet. Plus, we wanted to go to sleep early, because we haven't been sleeping much. We haven't had a proper meal in like almost 2 days. So
yeah.
So yeah, be pretty sure. Take care of our nutrition.
As many of you know at this point, Debbie has a thing for camels, so of course we had a quick stop in here. On the other hand, I have a thing for dogs. I mean, look at this little creature.
So yesterday night, right at the top over there used to be a easier trail that you could take up to go, and you could actually see it right there at the end. It was closed because a lady died in the trail, she fell off. Now later on we're going to take this trail over there so I can go all the way up to another viewpoint, which is right over there where the gentleman is, and it's not as hard as what we did yesterday night.
Little puppy.
We got to the treasury when it was sunset time, so slowly they start to ask everybody to leave. We were sad because we didn't even get a chance to get to the viewpoint as we wanted to, but luckily the Bedouin who took us yesterday night to the viewpoint was in there as well, so he convinced the owner of the area to let us go as an exception. Mentioned yet that Petra has a lot of puppies? We are truly grateful as none of this would have been possible without the help of these two Bedouins. The one who took us to today's viewpoint and the one who took us to yesterday's and pulled the string so we could get to today's. At the end of the day, we had a bit of time to explore Petra Visitor Center exhibition. In there, you find information on Nabateans, the people who built Petra, and on all the structures that you can see when you visit the area.
Esta é a maquete de Petra. Começa aqui com a parte por onde entramos. Tem restaurantes e lojinhas com o souvenir. Depois é o Visitor Center, onde vamos comprar os bilhetes. E tem um museu, que é onde estamos. A seguir, vocês começam a andar e começam a ver estas estruturas em forma de quadrados, cubos. Este aqui já não sabe o que é, também não viu.
Não sei como é que conseguimos perder uma coisa tão grande. Mas passámos três vezes lá, e não estava lá.
Aqui começa o canyon, que é o Sikh. Há toda esta voltinha, e aqui nesta abertura, vocês veem o treasure. Logo a seguir, se continuarem, tem uma espécie de mini canyon. Este risco aqui que vocês veem são escadas, que foi o trail que a gente fez até o High Place of Sacrifice. Depois a gente deu esta volta assim, até chegar ali. Aqui, mais ou menos. Contornamos basicamente a montanha no primeiro dia.
Teatro România.
Depois continuamos e vamos ter uma grande vista. Toda aquela montanha são tumbas dos reis, as maiores. Tem ali as escadinhas, que um beduíno explicou-nos que é para os levar para o céu, para os guiar para o céu. Continuamos, tem a Igreja Bizantina. Esta ruína por acaso a gente não viu e não sabemos o que é.
Não passámos nessas dúvidas.
Exatamente.
Foi as únicas coisas que não visitámos.
Depois aqui é um templo gigante.
Chama-se Great Temple.
Sim.
Por algum motivo.
Por algum motivo. É muito, muito grande. Depois tem aqui estas colunas que a gente passou e viu este templo. É um templo novamente. Isto aqui não dá para explorar. Está fechado por causa do elevado risco de desabamento.
Aqui do High Place of Sacrifice, nós voltámos pela montanha. E o outro caminho mais comprido até para marcado aqui, que é tipo, vir dar esta volta toda aqui e vai ter perto do Great Temple.
Continuando, vocês vão começar as 900 escadas que vos levam ao Monastery. mas antes, isto aqui é qualquer coisa do leão, já não me lembro. Por acaso não se pode ir para tirar fotos. Vale a pena passar por lá.
E não... não tem quase ninguém.
Não tem quase ninguém porque se desvia do caminho principal. Continuando a subir e a subir e a subir, há um monte de lojinhas e pessoas oferecendo chá. E dá para comprar sumos, refrescos, até gelados e ervas frigoríficas, eles têm lá em cima. Surpreendente. Lá no fundo vocês veem o Monastery, que é tipo
o Treasure, mas duas vezes maior. É mais ou menos o mesmo desenho, só que é muito, muito, muito grande.
Depois tenho aqui umas faixinhas muito boas para ter uma visão mais alta e para se ver o pôr do sol, que a gente não teve tempo para ver.
After having a better understanding on Petra, we headed towards a restaurant to have our first proper meal in 2 days. But I saw this on the way. I mean, I can't resist it.
For the first time we had a proper meal. It's a sandstone restaurant. We asked for a kebab. Basically, at the end, the guy charged us 3.5 dinar for fees. And that meal was 8, mine was 9. And they charge our meals at the same price. Water. But they didn't give us cups. They just brought the bottle of water to the table.
And this way, disappointed on our first proper meal, we finished our fourth Jordan vlog. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you had tons of fun. Please subscribe to the channel, leave a like and a comment. Make sure you hit that notification bell so you're the first one to know exactly when the next one is coming. And I'll see you on the next video. Bye!
It's so easy with me.